One of the types of assignments in this class are, well, in Blackboard, they're called assignments. This might be where you're submitting a paper. This could be where you're submitting pictures or a write-up or something like that. The other type of assignment are the tests and quizzes. Those are the ones that have short answer questions, multiple choice, matching, etc. So one of the things that you need to know how to do is how can you look at the feedback I've left you after you've submitted something? You might get a 50 out of 60, and maybe you're okay with just saying, okay, but if it were me, I would want to know why did I get a 50 out of 60? And this also helps you to improve in future assignments that you turn in. So in order to take a look at the feedback I've left, you will only see this after I've graded it, is if you click on My Grades, and then navigate down to the assignment that you're looking for. So I just submitted my environmental controversy paper final draft, and I want to take a look at the feedback that I got back from it. There's going to be feedback in a whole bunch of different places, so I'm going to outline each of them. First off, I got a 58.12 out of 60. I can click on this little speech bubble, and here's a comment. I got some extra credit for turning it in early. This is not your only feedback. The other thing you could click is View Rubric. This is probably pretty important to check out because this is going to give you the most accurate representation of why you got the scores you got. The rubric itself should be on all of the assignments, the handouts that I give you. It'll tell you exactly what you'll be graded on. I've just imported that into Blackboard to make it a little bit easier for me to grade. So for this rubric, here's the formatting section. Here's all the information about how you would get those points. And then here's my feedback. Okay, I got a 14 out of 16. I had a lot of spelling mistakes. See the paper. But your references look good. For the content, I got a 44 out of 44. I told you that was pretty nice. And then finally, I had some feedback down here just to let you know you did earn extra credit for it. So, although you can find information in those two places, what I recommend that you do is actually click on the title itself. It is in blue, showing you it's a link, although you can see here in Firefox, my cursor isn't actually changing. So, I click on the title, and here you're going to be able to view all of that feedback. Now, I'm going to make this screen a little bit bigger. You can do the same thing. I'm going to hide this left side column. So, if I get close to it, there's this new bar that pops up. I'm just going to click it. It hides away. You can click it again to show it, just to make this bigger. And here is your paper. It shows you your paper as well as my marks. And this is incredibly important because you might be turning in rough drafts, and I may use these tools to outline things. So I've underlined and circled some things. I've also left little comment bubbles along the way to give you some feedback. So definitely be sure to look through your entire paper to see if you see any of these blue bubbles or if you see any of my markings at all. You can also view that rubric again by clicking this little rubric icon. It's going to show you the same exact thing. It also shows you again that extra credit information. And then I also have, very well done. So just a remark overall. So again, I recommend taking a look at the link. So looking back at here is our paper final draft. You can see some of the information clicking the speech bubble. You can see some of the information clicking View Rubric. The only way to view all of the information all at once is to actually click on the assignment title. This is true for any assignment that you get any grade for. If for some reason you cannot view that feedback, you can try clicking on the other links. But if you have not received a perfect score, you will definitely have feedback as to why you missed certain points.